Well, I'm on the phone with head football coach Mark Arnold from MDI High School. And, Coach, it's Friday. It means another MDI football game tonight on the road. I think for the first time since 2012, taking on the Hampden Broncos.
Yep. We're heading back up there to play on the turf. The kids are excited and ready to go. They've had a good week of practice, and so we're ready for week two.
This is the first official football game on the turf. So I was up there when MDI played Hampden for exhibition soccer, and this turf field is quite amazing.
Yeah, I know that they replaced that over the summer. At the time, it seemed like it was pretty late in the spring when they announced that they were going to do it. So I know initially I was wondering if we were even going to play on this surface this year. But I know I've seen some pictures from earlier games up there, and it really looks nice. And it is a beautiful facility.
I think that they've made some adjustments in the lighting, too, because there were parts of the end zone that were dark, but I think that they've improved. We'll find out tonight. Hopefully, you'll be in the end zone in a lot, so we'll have to pay attention.
Right. We did see one game. We saw they played Herman up there for their preseason game the weekend that we played Ellsworth, and it seemed like it was lit up pretty good.
Yeah. So tell us how the week has gone, what you've worked on, and what do you think you need to do to, besides score more points, to win tonight?
Well, you know, throughout the week, I know one thing that we've been really emphasizing with our kids is we want to be a tougher football team this week than we were last week. You know, one of the things we've talked about this season is we've got a lot of new players. And, you know, last week we started, I believe, six sophomores on both sides of the football.
It's a lot.
Seven, really. And our next replacements were actually a couple of freshmen that came in and played for us during the course of the game. So, you know, you get younger kids like that, and one of the things that they normally learn in their first years as a part of a high school football team, I mean, a lot of freshmen would never really in the past touch the field for us in a varsity football game. And even as sophomores, you know, you start working them in. You have a couple of kids usually who are kind of standout players who get that opportunity and are ready for that. But we're in a position where we're putting more of those kids into play for us early here. They really worked hard in the off season, and what we're trying to do right now is we keep talking with our kids about, you know, we really need to jump a year in experience, and forcing that to happen isn't something that you can really do. It comes through that game experience, and so for our kids, we've really talked a lot this week. You know, our saying throughout this whole week was tough takes practice. And so we worked on that in practice this week, and then kind of our motto going into this game was we want to be tough to beat. And that's our goal for tonight, is that we go in and we become a more physical football team, and that's really important to us moving forward this season.
When you have worked this week, one of the things that was concerned last week was the penalties. How have you addressed that during practice? Is that part of the being tougher and not beating yourself?
Well, I think, you know, I mean, being tough, that really starts with being mentally tough and taking care of those things, like taking care of the football, not making, you know, kind of the mistakes, you know, where you're jumping off sides or committing penalties, blocking in the back, those types of things. The things we can control, we really worked on that this week, you know, just for us. And again, that's just part of the development of our discipline as a team. And I hope as the kids have become more familiar with our new offensive system and what we're doing, that those things, they don't take care of themselves. You definitely have to focus on them. But we have another week under us. And, you know, sometimes clearing up when you got so many things going on in your mind. I mean, imagine being a sophomore football player playing two ways.
Oh, yeah.
In your first varsity football game, you're bound to make some mistakes. And so each week we hope to improve on that, and that's just a process of drilling that in practice and, you know, layering in that learning so that, hey, when you get up to the line to run a play, we're hoping more things are just more instinctual, and you're not thinking about so many things before the snap of the ball. I think that will help us a lot in terms of our penalties.
With it being the first road game, that takes on a whole different challenge too, because now you've got to, especially with the young team, you've got to get everybody on the bus. You got to make sure that they've eaten, they got to make sure they're hydrated. I mean, all those little things, but they all add up. Because otherwise, if you haven't eaten something before the kickoff, I mean, come 8 o'clock, your stomach's growling and you can't even hear the signals because all there are tummies growling.
Right. I mean, we talk to our kids. You know, I sometimes think, I was thinking last night, like at the end of practice as I drove home, you know, the number of things on Thursday night that you remind kids about going into a Friday, it takes longer than the other nights. I mean, we try to consistently remind them about, you know, taking care of their bodies, sleeping, eating, and hydrating. I mean, that's something, you know, we preach every day with our kids. But on Thursday night, you have all those added things. We had to get them out their uniforms this morning. They had to come in. We had to make sure that they, you know, packed their equipment last night. And then really just going through that process of, okay, the bus is going to leave at this time. You know, you need to have gone through checking your helmet, all those little things, not only for the players, but, you know, just for us as a team. This is, we got to load the bus and make sure we got the headsets and that everything's ready to go.
Right.
It's not like
you can't,
being at home.
You can't dash back to the gym and pick something up.
Right. You know, you got to have it with you and ready to go. And so, I think we're set to go. I got all my stuff right here by the door, so I'm hoping that we've prepared our kids in that same way, that they're ready to hit the bus and go. And then it's just a matter of, you know, how to travel as a team, because, you know, when you're here at school, we've gone kind of through, we bring them in for meetings early here, and that kind of starts the process. And so we take control of that sooner as coaches. When it's a home game, when it's an away game, you know, you got that time on the bus, you get there, and we don't have that, you know, setup where we bring them into meetings. So all of that is a little bit different, and they need to start getting ready. I mean, we told them when we drive up, there's a certain spot where we expect it to be quiet on the bus, and they start that mental process of getting ready for the game. But this will be a first go for that. And one of the really important things is, you know, our seniors they've had experience traveling with
right.
us, and they know our expectations. And so we put a lot on our seniors to say, hey, this is your job to lead the team and show them what it's like to travel and what our expectations are.
Give us the three keys for victory tonight for MDI, if you would.
Well, again, that thing that I talked about earlier, for us, we need to be a tougher football team than we were last week. You know, I thought we did a good job in terms of fighting till the end of the game last week. Our kids were resilient. But this week, you know, we want to go out and just be tougher football players. I told all our kids, when you walk off the field tomorrow night, I'm not so interested in the scoreboard. I mean, we obviously want to win the football game. All our kids certainly do. But I want them to get back on that bus, you know, a tougher kid in terms of how they play football than they were when we walked out onto the field. And so, you know, we did talk with them, same thing, about keys to the game are always our special teams are important, possession, you know, keeping possession of the football and not having turnovers, that's important to us. But I want our kids definitely to go out there you know, play a tougher style of football tonight than we did a week ago.
Your secondary is going to be tested tonight against Hampden. You've told me they like to put the ball up in the air.
Yeah, you know, in breaking them down, they've thrown the ball about, I think it was almost 65% of their offensive plays that we scouted them in the past two games. So that's a lot of throwing the football.
Right.
For the teams we've played normally, and that's really, I think, in the time I've been here, about the highest percentage that I've seen from a team. And they like to put the ball up deep. They've practiced it a lot. You know, they compete in 7-on-7 over the course of the summer aggressively. They have some excellent skill kids and a good quarterback. And so we've worked really hard on that this week. For us, we have some younger players in our secondary. We lost our entire secondary last year, so that's a place that's going to be tested for us, and it's an opportunity for us to mature there. You know, no matter the outcome tonight, again, we want our kids to be better football players leaving the game than when they entered it, and this will certainly test us in one way that we really don't see that often, but in all games, it comes into play, so... there'll be some benefit to playing a team like that. And Hampden has a solid running game, too. And I think, you know, high school football, you always got to be prepared to stop the running game. And so we focused on both, but we've really put an extra emphasis this week working with our kids in the secondary.
All right, the game tonight on WDEA Internet Radio at WDEA.AM. You can also hear it on our free downloadable app sponsored by First National Bank. And on any Alexa-enabled device. Coach, best of luck. We'll talk to you on Monday.
All right. Thank you, Chris. You have a good night, and we'll see you over at the game.